Hey, how's it going? Train is here. Welcome back to Grimdan. So, this time, with an occultist necromancer build, I was tempting to try this out, because I had found a lot of items with my other character. So, the occultist, like the shaman and necromancer, this one also has minions to summon. So we have the summon familiar here, and also the summon hellhound here. Now, both the summon familiar and summon hellhound are pretty weak if you don't put enough points into them. So I would recommend just leveling up those two at the start as fast as you can. Also nice, the familiars can also be summoned at level 1. Same for the race skeletons, for example. But the familiar, pretty good one. Also a couple of nice usable skills. So we got Mend Flesh. It is basically a heal in a small area. Just put 1 point in this and level it up later. It is pretty good to level, but I would rather put my points in something that will buff all my pets at this time, because I don't have a full build yet. The next ability, Storm Spirit. It is a passive. It is activated on all your other pets, so pretty nice. Also good in combination with, for example, the Summon Hellhound, because of the more elemental damage. And we also have the Lightning Strike here. It's just a lightning bolt from above, stuns the target, and it also deals massive damage. So definitely level this one up later, if you want more damage for your familiar. But yeah, pretty good one to check out. But as I said, always level up this one first, because the Raven of itself is pretty weak. Then I went for the Curse here, the Curse of Frailty, just because I wanted to try something else, and also because this one just slows the enemies and gives them less resistance. So more damage overall for my pets. And also the enhanced one. So this ability. Also elemental resistance minus is pretty good. So yeah, nice ability. I would just recommend putting 1 point in each of these. And get plus skills to increase them. Then I also went for the Blood of Dreek. Now this one is a little bit strange because it mostly applies to me. But, for example, the heal from this ability will also activate on all my pets and all my allies. So this is pretty nice, and I would like to have a sort of panic skill. So I can just press this. Aspect of the Guardian, it enhances this skill, I believe. But I'm not sure if this one also works on your allies. So I'm still not sure about it. But yeah, 1 point couldn't hurt. Just increase it with plus skills. Then I went for the Bonds of Bismil here. I really want to get to Manipulation, because all my pets will get more all damage and more total speed. But for now, I just put 1 point in this, increase it with plus skills. But I would recommend leveling up this one later, because you get a lot of health from this skill. And now same for this one, because of the total speed. The Hellhound, it is a pretty good one. Especially if you level it up quickly. Then we have the Ember Claw. It's okay. I would not recommend putting too much points into this one. And filling up other things first. The Hellfire. This one is a must. Pretty good one. Also passive buffs to all your pets and allies. With fire damage, chaos damage, burn damage. I would recommend leveling up this one a little bit. Not too much, but if you have points to spend, better use it on these, on the Hellfire and or the Storm Spirit, instead of the damage skills at the beginning. I will go to the Infernal Breath here, because I need the manipulation, but yeah, it is strong, but it requires a lot of points, so I'm not sure yet about this. Further, nothing really for pets, so I would recommend just leaving the rest of the tree hello? Well, we've spoken about this one before, but just a quick overview. So I went full Race Skeletons here again, also full the Undead Legion, and also full the Will of the Crypt. This is because the skeletons are your weakest characters and weakest allies, so buffing them is a must to keep them a little bit alive. I also went for the Bone Harvest here, just because I also needed the extra skill. And because I am going to this point later, so I can get a bonus to all pets here. rest is just a little bit of attack, slower target movement speed, but nothing special here. Then I went for the Blight Fiend again. So it will take a while before I will level up these, but as before, just pick this one once and level up this one if you can have points to spend. I won't go to the Master of Death here or the Call of the Grave because I want to try to be more passive, so I only have this one for now, the Blood of Dreek. But yeah, so far it is pretty strong. I really like it, especially I am a fan of the familiar here. I just really like this pet. Looks good, feels nice. I always recommend setting this to normal so it will follow you. But yeah, pretty good one. The Hellhound also okay, as I said before, but I would prefer the familiar. Just really like this pet. So also a quick look at the devotions I have right now. I have a couple already, so only need 10. But I went for the Jackal here, so just for the constellation bonus, a little bit of health, a little bit of attack speed. Then I went for the Fiend again, so fire damage, and the Flame Torrent. Now I bound this one to my Hellhound. A little bit different because I don't have the Briatorn on this build. I think the fire with the Hellhound works pretty good. Then I went for the Shepherd Skull again. Just for the extra health and the active ability, of course, with my attack. This is also why I need the Bone Harvest. But yeah, I would always recommend picking the Shepherd Skull up here. It is pretty easy to do and it gives massive damage to your pets, so definitely check this one out. Then I went a little bit to the bottom here, so I went for the Raven. The reason why I picked this is just because of the lightning damage, so this is pretty good for my familiar. And also the base lightning damage works for all my other pets. Then I went for the Manticore here. Poison damage, health, fence ability, poison damage and also the acid spray. So I put my Blight Fiend into this, just because he also deals acid and poison damage. And maybe they can buff each other, I'm not sure yet how this works. Also went for the Toad. Defense ability, attack damage converted to health, and the offense ability. I picked this one also because I needed the constellation bonus. Then I went for the elemental storm again. I just picked this one up because it is only 3 points and yeah, the elemental storm is pretty good on the race skeletons. So I also went for the Wolverine here because I needed the constellation bonus, but also the Wolverine gives pretty good resistance to your pets. So we got defense ability, bleeding resistance, poison and acid resistance, pretty good, hard to get. Fatality resistance, also the pierce resistance. I also have the Mordrogon the Wolf here. So defense ability, 30% to all damage, 8% total speed, always nice to have. Nothing for my pets here. 80% to all damage, also nice, some defense for me. And I also got the Howl of Mordrogon now. So this one is really good, gives bonus to all pets, total speed, defense ability, and it can also be activated on my curse for example. So I have now equipped this on my curse, and since I curse everything, this one activates a lot. So pretty good one to pick up. It's also not really that hard to pick up, so you can get there pretty quickly if you just build towards this point. Now, because I have 10 points left, I'm still a bit looking what I will take next, but I'm thinking about a Fisher here, and especially because this one can also be bound to some of my pets. So I'm looking forward to this one on my pets. I think it is pretty good. I have seen it before, but not on a pet build. So yeah, that is my plan for now. The items, real quick. I just have a random sword here. Just a ring with bonus to all pets, nothing good. Plus one to skills, necromancer. It's alright. Yellow ring. Really need to be replaced. Pretty good amulet. I just found this while leveling. So I have the Ognapesh here. I just equipped this one because I really want more pets. And I will try to focus more on total speed in this build. I got Rover Shoulders, of course. Definitely check them out. You can get them if you are respected status with the Rovers. Just random gloves with a bit of total speed and bit of health for my pets. Bit of bonus to all pets on the boots. Rare metal with bonus. Then I got an occultist belt with bonuses. Plus one to all skills and occultist and bonuses, so that's pretty nice. Then I have the Savage as a relic at the moment. I'm looking to replace this one, but the Summon Stormhound is pretty okay. The bonus to all pets bonuses of this one are also pretty good. The pants, just some bonus to all pets. The Rover Cuirass, of course, with the Summon Familiar, Undead Legion, and also bonuses to all pets. I got a weapon waiting and a offhand waiting. So I have this weapon. The raised skeletons, plus one summon limit, and also a lot of bonuses to all pets. So I can wear this on 55, I'm now 51. And I have also this one. I'm not sure if I will equip it on 65, but I was able to craft this by the blacksmith. Also good bonus to all pets, and Infernal Breath. So Infernal Breath is this one, I mean. So, good options to pick up later. But maybe I will keep the Ogna Pesher and go for the mythical version of or the empowered version. But yeah. So we have Ogna Pesh, we have the Familiar, we have the Blight Fiend, we have the Stormhound, we also have the Hellhound. So big army already, and then we have all the skeletons. But yeah, so far I'm enjoying it. As I said before, I really like the Familiar. I just think it is a cool pet, and also the Hellhound. I was always a bit negative about this one, but I have to say, it deals alright damage, and it is better than I expected. Definitely check out the Occultist Necromancer if you don't like Shaman. You can of course also pick the Shaman with the Occultist together, so you skip the Necromancer. I can really recommend the Occultist together with the Necromancer. But for now, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like. And I see you in the next one. Bye.